Welcome back to the show from the Issaquah Salmon Hatchery tonight. You know, we frequently hear about kids being bullied at school and the terrible effects that that can have. Well, believe it or not, but the same thing happens among adults in the workplace. And now there's a local company working to expose workplace bullies. And the advice comes from personal experience. Here's Kim Griffith.
Excuse me, what is this?
Sweet and low?
No. This is not sweet and low. This is equal. Blue packet. Sweet and low is pink.
Over a bucket of popcorn, it can be kind of funny to watch a movie about some poor soul getting verbally beat up by a boss.
I asked you to go get me a packet of sweet and low. You bring me back equal. Then that shit isn't going to work around here.
But it's not so funny when it's you.
Oh, and I almost forgot. I'm also going to need you to go ahead and come in on Sunday.
From the mailroom to the boardroom, bullies are wreaking havoc at work, and they're getting away with it. One in six workers feels they've been bullied. Of those who've been targeted, 82% lost their jobs as a result. Not the bully, the target.
So how do you know if your boss or coworker is just a bit of a jerk or annoying, or a real bully? It becomes bullying when their behavior is so damaging it makes you psychologically or physically sick.
It got so bad that I'd have to stop my car on the freeway, pull over, and throw up before I got to work.
Dr. Ruth Namey still gets upset when talking about her former supervisor at a California clinic. Ruth eventually left that job, but not before her reputation and her health were put through the ringer.
So I got very depressed. It took me a year to realize that I didn't do anything wrong, and that's when we started what we do, because we figured we didn't want anybody else to go through what we went through.
Ruth and her husband, Dr. Gary Namey, now run the Workplace Bullying and Trauma Institute, based in Bellingham.
What are we trying to do? Are we trying to get the union involved to push employer?
They field calls from all over the world.
This is one of those ever-present phenomena that just destroys and erodes organizations from within.
They speak to packed houses and have even published a new book, The Bully at Work. It's all in an effort to educate people about a problem that's been quietly claiming victims for years.
30% of bullied women in the workplace get post-traumatic stress. It shouldn't be. I mean, that's a war wound. For them, the workplace is a war zone. It's madness. It's crazy.
And it was like every minute of every day there, what is going to happen next? What is it going to be today?
For Bonnie McAllister, the bullying at the insurance company where she worked was so devastating, she's now on disability.
Emails would pop up that was meant to be sent to someone else and putting me down, ridiculing me, saying, well, we'll do this afternoon.
You have no brain.
There ought to be a law, but there isn't. Most people bullied at work are not in a legally protected group. Harassment laws and policies usually don't apply. So what if you have a bully at work? The Namey's suggest, first of all, name it.
By naming it bullying, what you're doing is you're taking control of the phenomenon. You're externalizing the problem.
Next, take some time off to shore up your health and solidify your game plan. And then expose the bully, not just to your boss, but to a boss or two above them. Make the case that the bully is too expensive to keep.
The bully cost this many dollars, caused this many mental health claims, caused this many legal settlements. Would you like to provide relief to me? Because I would like relief. I would like the bully to be transferred, blah, blah. And you lay it out. We're getting more and more success stories. This is happening.
Both Ruth and Bonnie simply got out. Had they been armed with bully-proofing information or a policy or law to help, things may have turned out differently. The Namey's hope as people become more aware, bullies will be exposed and unable to do their damage.
We're both rational adults here.
Hollywood has an answer to the workplace bully. Probably not a good idea.
No, definitely not a good idea. So to help people cope, October has been named National Bullying Prevention Month. It's the fifth year for this. There are some great tips on how to prevent bullying. We'll put a link on our website.